more specifically, is just I want that top end to reach out. So a lot of times, like with bass, not so much with this sub bass because it's pretty much a sine wave, the sub, but if it was a live bass, a lot of times people will go and just start adding low end, thinking, I want to be able to hear the bass. Really what you want is the fingers, and the fingers is up here in the top end. So it's kind of like, it's not as apparent just what you think, like, oh, I want more bass. Oh, let me add more bass. Well, it's actually the fingers of the bass that's going to cut through the mid-range. Again, that's what I'm trying to impress upon y'all, is like, focus on that mid-range to make sure that mid-range is going to translate. A lot of times what I do, once I get a mix like 70%, I'll just bounce it and play it off my phone. How's it translating off of this? Because people are going to listen off this. Yep. You know, how many times have you heard a song and you're like, I can't get to the car right now. You're like, what's that new Jay-Z song like? What's that new whatever song like? And you're listening to it and you're like, that's cool. And it better sound good, you know?